VIP.
Got the Corvettes hanging out here at the air show. Beautiful. That's my dream car right there, folks. Chevrolet Corvette. I've loved those since I was a little kid. Got a lot of food vendors set up here too. Lots of good food choices today. Out there getting all set. There's something on fire in the distance. We're going into this plane to try to walk through a little bit. I think that might be a C-130. But correct me if I'm trying to go take a look at.
Must have been a tough
lady. Yeah. A menacing looking crack right there.
Texas. Farthest from us in the other airplane is Ken Reeder from Cincinnati, Ohio. They are Redline air shows. Aired on that fort, and he feared that during the night the British would overtake the fort. But the next morning, he didn't see a white flag of surrender. Instead, he saw a huge 32-foot by 40-foot American flag flying above the fort, indicating an American victory. As we see the flags come in, including the one from the 377th, high up above we have the American flag. Applause too for all of the jumpers. Master Sergeant Luke Whittington, Sergeant First Class Andrew Davis, Team Unit. Big round of applause for MAG 49. Our specialty additives manufacturing plant services, the marine shipping industries, railroads, the automotive. In 2005, when he was at Oklahoma State University, and watch him tear the sky into little pieces and give it back to you like confetti in a 9-inch speed, falling at about 4,000 feet per second. This is just a teaser of what he'll be doing in his solo as he works not only as a solo but also with Ken Reeder of Redline. Experiencing 10 times the force of gravity, a hard roll and a quarter to the right, he'll run out of airspeed. Gyroscopic tumbling maneuvers. Now she's fallen out of the sky right now. She's in a flat spin. The airplane isn't flying. It's falling at about 3,000 feet per minute. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 turns. 6, 7, 8. but this one has a 200 horsepower motor on it and enables her to do some tumbling maneuvers and just some remarkable aerobatic maneuvers that you will love. And we'll be going live to the cockpit to talk to Jesse during her performance in just a couple of seconds. Going by right now on the ground is Adam Baker. Now let's watch as the roll goes by. Aerobatics by the legendary Marion Cole.
Listen to that sound. That's awesome.
Soloed on his 16th birthday. That is the youngest age at which a person in the United States can fly an airplane solo. Mustang has its roots going way back to 1940. British Purchasing Commission, he came up with a brand new airplane in 120 days and not Bill Curtis P-40 Warhawks, but he had the rabbit to pull out of the hat.
That's right, in 117 days they completed the airframe, and the only thing they were waiting on was
producing the Merlin engines from Rolls-Royce. The only thing you can add to Merlin Magic, that sound, is the sound of the howl of those gun barrels. That was amazing. You know, it was in 1943 that then Senator Harry Truman, later to become President of the United States. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you will, look to the left, you will see and hear the sound of freedom. Sam Joplin, call sign Nuke. Here's Lieutenant Colonel Hens taking off. Being poured into the exhaust. You can see the flames coming out the back and maybe see little diamonds in that flame. Take a look at it. As you watch it now, as a predecessor of mine, Bill Bordlow, who used to announce this show over 20 years ago, said, "This is the world's biggest big light." It weighs 7,000 pounds. It set a world speed record in the Guinness Book of World Records. It's certified at a top speed of 376 miles per hour. J-34 jet engines that power it have been modified with afterburners. I talked a big time, the engine pops now. That's the little cha-cha. Chris's crew chief, Wayne Rachel, is already headed down to the start point. We're going to see a run on this. It's going to be going by.
50 gallons. And when he lights off down here at the left end of the show area, pops the brakes on that, and it's full afterburner. It is an amazing ride. I did it Monday.
60 in 1.2 seconds. There's 120, 175, 2, 225, 275 right there, just shy of 300 miles per hour in less than 2,000 feet. Let's hear it for Chris Darnell.
Now the responsibility of the flight mechanic who's back there.
The Hornet Diamond Photo Pass.
And so this is a great way for the Marines and the LZ to communicate with the pilots. Gulf Breeze, Florida, and then our crew chief, Staff Sergeant Andrew Sylvania, and Corporal Monzon from Azusa, California.
When the Coast Guard was here earlier, I made mention of the fact how difficult it is to hover, learn to hover a helicopter. I used the phrase, standing on a beach ball, rubbing your tummy and patting your head at the same time, whatever it is. It's that challenging at the beginning, isn't it?
So it's that challenging in the beginning. Luckily, as technology has gotten better, what you can see in these helicopters is they have stability and control systems.
Try to give you an idea of how many people actually came to this thing today.
Lots of people. Here comes the F-16.
Focus on it, it's going so fast. Love it. B-52 bomber. Started up the Blue Angels.